Representative Marquardt, as we sit here today, a week or so before Governor Dayton is scheduled to give his final State of the State address, how do you see the state of the state in March 2018?
Well, I think we're moving in the right direction. You know, you just had the budget forecast come out, and it's positive, not great, but moving in the right direction. Unemployment rate low, job growth this last year was good. So overall, we're sitting good. Are there pockets and areas around the state that still need improvement? Yes, absolutely, a lot in rural Minnesota. But for the most part, Minnesota's on the right track, looking good.
And what do you hope to hear from the governor during his address?
This year should have been kind of a routine year, but with some of the things that are going on, it's become much more than that. And so I think the governor is going to talk about how to continue to move the economy forward. But also, we've got a tax bill we're going to have to do to conform to the federal tax bill. And then, of course, a big area that has come up, you know, just maybe recently, but been long term, is school safety. And I know as I've talked to schools in my area, that's a huge concern, is not only on the facility side, how to make schools safer and, you know, secure, but also the mental health side for students, kind of two things there. And then, you know, broadband. I'm hoping the governor talks about kind of getting to our final goals in broadband, that last 250,000 households that don't have the proper speeds and so forth. I'm hoping we can do that too.
The recently released February forecast projected $329 million surplus for the remainder of this biennium. What do you think should be done with that money?
I think there's kind of three areas. And number one is, I mentioned before, in the school safety area. I think that's really important, not only for facilities. I mean, we've got schools looking at, you know, fortifying locks on doors or securing their entrances or being able to employ a school resource officer. And then on the other side, the mental health issues, the more staffing and so forth. So that's, I think that would be a great use for the surplus. We've got to fix that driver's license debacle. And, you know, you hate to just continue to throw money at it, but we've got to do it. And it's actually what's encouraging, they're moving in the right direction. And so we've got to continue that and get that done for the folks back home. And the third area I probably mentioned too is the broadband. I was very encouraged by a recent, the governor's broadband task force report that said there's about 250,000 people, almost all in rural Minnesota, that aren't to the 25 megabytes per second download speed. With federal funding and so forth, over the next 4 years to meet that goal, it would cost about $35 million a year of state dollars. That's very doable. I hope we do that because broadband is the great economic equalizer in rural Minnesota. And so if we're going to have a state economy that is across the state and growing, we've got to make sure we get that broadband out to rural Minnesota.
As DFL lead of the House Taxes Committee, how is the 2017 federal tax law affecting the state, and what needs to happen in order to get federal conformity accomplished in 2018?
There's a number of things in that tax bill that has huge impacts on Minnesota. And so while a lot of people will see a tax break on the federal side, what we don't want to happen is they come back then to fill out their Minnesota taxes and they go up. So we're going to have to deal with some areas, especially with that part where the federal government increases the standard deduction but eliminates the personal exemptions. And in the long run, what happens for most families is Minnesota, when we come back to fill out our Minnesota income taxes, we start with the federal taxable income. And because of the loss of the personal exemptions, we're going to have a higher federal taxable income, a starting point, than we did under current law, which will raise taxes on folks. So we need to somehow keep that so that folks don't see that increase. And there's also some implications on the business side too. So doing nothing is not an option. And so, you know, I'm sure the governor, I think the day after the state of the state, is going to put out his budget, but also his kind of tax proposal. And so we'll know a little bit more then. But, you know, last year we had a tax bill, and normally in this year we wouldn't have another one. Now with the federal tax bill, we need to have one, and it's probably going to be more complicated doing it this year than last year. But we need to do that. We have to make sure we target and gear those dollars to hardworking Minnesotans, because in the federal tax bill, the benefits they see are only temporary. We have to make sure they're permanent and kind of balance the federal plan in making sure that folks in the lower to middle income are seeing some tax breaks.
What kind of bonding proposal in terms of dollars makes sense this session?
Well, I think around $1 billion. You know, I know the governor's at about 1.5 billion and a lot of the, what I'm hearing is maybe 800 million. But the, you know, we had one last year. I think if we could get to $1 billion, that would be realistic. I think that would be a good bipartisan approach. And I think we'd be able to fund a lot of the things we're looking at doing. You know, the colleges and universities, I know in the governor's Dayton's bill is a big priority, as it should be. I think that's good. There's still flood mitigation in my neck of the woods up and down the Red River Valley. You know, those are all types of great projects that I think would fit in there. And one other area that is big around the state, and I know the governor has been a big proponent of this, is getting money to cities for their wastewater and drinking water needs. That's a huge issue around the state. And so I'm hoping there's a real investment in the bonding bill in those areas.
And just finally, what is your optimism level that, though short, the 2018 session will be successful?
I always consider myself a naive optimist. And so I think all of the issues we've talked about right now are really all bipartisan issues. And I think the chances are good we're going to come together and deal with this, because every one of these issues we've talked about right now are vitally important to the folks back home. And so I'm optimistic that in the end, and I'm not saying we're going to finish early, typically we go right to the end, but I think we're going to get things done, and I think it's going to be a good, productive session for Minnesotans.